We're heading to Coeur d'Alene. Did you press record?
Yes. All right. Off to a good start already.
We just ate at Denny's. We were starving.
Well, actually, let's back up. We were just deposited in Idaho.
Yeah, exactly. And now we're heading to Coeur d'Alene. The view, as you notice, is beautiful. As soon as I got to the airport, I was the only Hispanic in this part of the country. I'm looking for my people. So if you find a bodega, a fritura stand, or anything close by, I'll let you know.
Going guava shopping later.
So we're heading over to the shop, and I'll see you guys later.
The expo,
yeah.
We have just Coeur d'Alene, the expo, to check things out. And it is beautiful here. Lots of trees, mountains.
Oxygen.
Yes, lots of oxygen. Okay, so far I've gotten the road.
Okay, you can stop recording.
Arriving at Coeur d'Alene City Park, on left.
Okay, wow. There's Lake Coeur d'Alene. Wow. It's beautiful. We are headed to Ironman, Idaho, Coeur d'Alene 2008. It is 4:30 in the morning.
4:45.
The sun is already coming up. The scenery is amazing, and Hector's gonna come in first place, kick some butt, and I'm gonna be the spectator of the day. I've carved up, I'm ready to go, and I am going to be the winner in the spectator department. Okay, enough about me. Hector Torres, Ironman 2008. Why'd you check your watch?
Well, I just checked my heart was on.
Okay. Tell us how you plan to beat Heather Feuer and Chris McCormick.
But they're not racing.
Exactly. Good point.
No, today's gonna be a good day. I have a little bit of anxiety is coming in, but that's normally in every single race morning. Just going over everything in my head, knowing exactly what I need to do, going the positive self-talk, a lot of visualization, and a lot of talking. So,
Notice that people walk away from you when you're self-talking?
Yes, okay. Because I talk out loud. No, today's gonna be a great day. I'm really excited. It's my first Ironman in which, it's my second Ironman, but my first Ironman in which I feel ready. My first Ironman, I was shitting my pants. I was like, so scared, but this one I'm good. Really, really good.
Alright.
So, I'll see you guys at the pool.
There you have it, Hector Torres, Ironman 2008. We're going biking tomorrow after all.
This is Hector. Dripping for the Von Martin
experience. Sorry, I'm right here.
Yeah, fine. That's okay.
Your number is?
I have no idea.
Hector is number 341. And if you missed that, he just shivered when they touched him with the cold marker. He is shivering. It is so cold. It's about in the 50s.
You are? Florida from Jacksonville.
And my age, 30.
Yeah, we were just telling people.
I think he's supervising his own body marking, which I'm not sure what that's about. And the old man is trying to make conversation, and he is not interested. He's like, I have a race to do, let's move on and have a day. Okay, it is organized chaos. There are people everywhere. I'm taking a picture of people taking a picture.
I just can't go over the mat because I got a chip.
Hector is ready. This is down there, I think. This is the bike. area.
It's cold.
5:15 in the morning, and
there's daylight.
Daylight. We're amazed. I think it gets daylight about 4:15 here. I think this is the first race we've ever been to where the sun is up. We're disoriented. We're gonna swim into the mountain.
Hector Torres,
Ironman 2008. Getting ready to go in the water in about 30 minutes.
This is not deodorant.
Yeah, we wish.
Oh, there's a lot. He's got wetsuit on and ready to go. He's got the team shirt on.
The last thing you want is to get chafing around your neck. And this is all silicone. A gigantic hot dog.
I was going to ask if there are any last words, but what do you say after that?
To the swim. Good luck today at the 6th annual
17 hours of torture is not fun. Only for crazy people.
That was Spain. This will be shorter.
No, this is going to be it's going to be a lot of fun. I look forward to it. I'm ready. Alright, bye.
What do you say?